In this video, we'll demonstrate a basic Dante network setup using a few Dante-enabled products. A basic Dante network is easy to set up and requires no special training in computer networks to get up and running. Dante is a true plug-and-play system that automates all essential functions for you. In this demonstration, we're showing a network comprised of a Dante-enabled mixer, wireless mic, and power amp all connected with an off-the-shelf network switch. We're leaving all Dante settings at defaults. Before we use Dante for audio, we must connect all our devices with a network switch. Fortunately, in most setups, this isn't complicated and does not require special knowledge. Connect common Cat5e or Cat6 Ethernet cables to the primary ports of your Dante devices, and then to any port on a gigabit network switch. Please see our website at autonate.com for switch recommendations that suit your environment. Please note that Dante does not work over Wi-Fi or wireless connections. We rely upon the incredible reliability of wired Ethernet to deliver flawless audio performance. Finally, connect a computer that has Dante Controller installed to the network as well. We'll need that to configure our Dante audio subscriptions and device settings. Once Dante is configured, the computer may be removed from the network if it is not being used for recording or audio processing. When we connect our Dante devices together, they form a network that's automatically detected by any connected computer that's running Dante Controller. Dante Controller discovers all devices immediately. There's no need to tell it about your network. As you can see, the devices we've just connected now appear in Dante Controller and are ready to use. Now that our devices are connected, let's make some channel subscriptions and get audio flowing between the components of our system. When we click on the plus sign near each device name, we can see all the audio channels for that device. These channels can be user-labeled to make it easy to understand and remember our connections. Notice that our devices appear on each axis, with receiver channels on the vertical axis and transmitter channels on the horizontal. Since our first device is our source, we'll open it along the transmitter axis to show the channels that send audio. Let's open a second device that we like to connect to. Since it is the destination for our audio, we'll open it along the receiver axis. We'll connect the wireless mic to our mixer. Now we can see the transmitter channels from our first device and the receiver channels of our second device. The area where these intersect form a grid of channels to work with. To connect channels, we simply have to click right where the desired transmitter and desired receiver channels intersect. When we click at that intersection, a green checkbox appears, indicating a successful subscription has been made. We can hear that audio is flowing, coming from our transmitter, the wireless mic, and going to our receiver, the mixer. One of the great things about Dante is that subscriptions are remembered by each device. If we disconnect the devices or turn them off altogether, all the connections are remembered automatically when the system is reassembled. If we disconnect our devices, they disappear from Dante Controller. But as soon as they're reconnected, all the devices come back. Not only do our devices automatically reappear, but all the subscriptions we've made come back as well. This allows you to dismantle a system knowing that all your connections will be there when you reassemble it. Our next video focuses on Dante Virtual Soundcard, software that allows you to record and play out up to 64 channels of audio directly from your Mac or PC with a Dante network.